We are at rest at the front. Our bellies are full of beef and haricot beans. We are satisfied and at peace. This is the front. Now we are within its embrace. This is the first time I have killed with my hands, whose death is my doing. This man has an invisible dagger which stabs my thoughts.
Hi, Dad. How are you?
Really, Dad? Are you kidding me? You can't even say hi?
I'm busy reading.
If you're gonna act like a child, I'm gonna have to treat you like a child.
Sure.
What do you even mean? What does that even mean? Why do you always read those dumb books?
Because I'm in a hospital, and we don't have the luxury of TVs.
Well, perhaps we should move you to a higher state-of-the-art hospital.
No, I like it here. Everybody understands my mind. I don't feel insane, because all their minds travel back in time to that horrible time, too.
Dad, you're certifiably insane!
I've suffered enough hardship in my life. Let me choose how I live.
I'm in control of your health, so I get to choose rightfully what you do.
Barbara, your generation doesn't realize how much we've had to deal with in our times. We've had war, segregation, disease, and all your generation can think about is technology and control.
I probably know more about all of that than you do.
There you go again. My entitled daughter. I'm ashamed. I wish you were alive during the war. Then you wouldn't be like this.
Whatever, you're never gonna listen to me anyways. You're a stubborn mule, and you know I'm right.
All right, gentlemen,
we'll see you back at base. Taking this young worker staffer out for his first patrol.
Hit the deck! Where the hell are they? Private, get some goddamn cover! You're in the open! Private Posse, get the hell over here! What the hell are you doing in open?
Going quiet. Where is that son of a bitch?
There he is! You got a lot to learn. We gotta get the hell back to base, Private.
Hell, there you go, Private. 21. Looks like you learn something new every day, huh?
No, my father was telling me about learning.
Captain, we got some goofs out in Northwest. We need a patrol right now.
All right. Newbie and I are on it.
Captain, the hell are they?
I don't know. This is Northwest Quadrant. Move it! Right over there! Get him! No, it's just a couple. We got it.
What do you think of that, Captain?
Well, I'll be damned, Private. Another win.
Captain, there's
a racer going on at SoCal. There's a racer. We need help. We need all the
troops. Wait, I'm taking out
Captain. We got this one. Let's go. Private, need some fire.
Captain, get over here.
On the count of three. One. I'm hit!
Captain,
Captain, come on. We gotta get up. Let's go.
Stay alive for me, son. Take it for me.
Captain, come on. Dukes are all around. We gotta go. We gotta come with me.
You become quite a man, Private. You can make it on your own.
No, come on.
Go.
Come on.
Go. Go. Get out of here. Go.
So MI6 is bothering retired agents now.
I've come to tell you long before you were forced to retire. Control made a discovery.
Right. Come sit.
And what sort of discovery would that be?
Well, we both know that Operation Testify was Control's baby. And when it failed miserably, the intel we were supposed to receive was lost. However, Control got this out.
And what is this?
That is proof of a Soviet mole in MI6.
Do we know who?
No. Only it's there.
So what's our plan? Any intel? Anything? We have to go over this carefully, for all of MI6 could be affected.
Well, our American friends have narrowed it down to our top three senior officers. Adeline, Bill Hayden, and Roy Bland.
The only three not affected by Operation Testify as follows.
Precisely.
Before we left, Control assigned each of the top three a code name, that in the event of him being discovered, we would just say the corresponding word. Adeline, Tinker. Bill Hayden, Taylor. And Roy Bland, Soldier.
So then what do you need me for?
Well, you're the only person I can trust. Anyways, I'll drop you off at Adeline's safe house. Try not to make it obvious, just question about testifying.
Smiley, is that you? I thought you retired.
I did, I just came to ask some questions about Operation Testify.
Huh, Operation Testify, that was a mess.
I sent Whelan, he's a trusted agent.
Why send me here? We know it's either Bill Hayden or Roy Bland.
Well, your question's about Testify?
Yeah, why about that? Why send our best agents after some Czechoslovakian general? All we know, those secrets could have been taken from the Americans. Why do we have to go in there to get them?
That general knew the name of the mole. That's what Control got out.
Ah, so the mole must have been one of the top three.
Exactly. Hayden or Bland.
So the mole must have alerted Soviet High Command about Operation Testify. But then why would you send our best agents in?
I had to do something. Britain is losing ground to the US and the Soviet Union. Our networks have been flooded by Soviets and Americans. We don't even know who's British anymore.
So back to Bland and Hayden. Where are they now?
Last I knew, they were meeting an American double agent at their safe house.
Right. I'll take Guilin, and I'll get that mold.
Thank you. One of you is a mole for the Soviet service and will be arrested on behalf of Her Majesty's service.
Smiley?
I will be taking both of you in for interrogation at MI6.
The British?
The bloody Americans.
You're only taking him. Roy Bland is with me.
Roy Bland? You're the American double agent. And you're the Soviet mole.
Guido, ready to transport. We've got him.
Frank! Come on, Bill. How's betraying us worth it?
Jay, Smiley, been out of service for 2 weeks and you're already blind. 20 years I got defected. 20 years, Smiley. And it took until now for someone like you to find out.
20 years? What made you do it 20 years ago?
It all started with the Suez. The Americans left us out to dry. We had nothing. They pushed us around like another one of their satellites. No longer treated as equals.
I left. So it's gonna get better pay. Allow me to work against the Americans.
Her Majesty's service thanks you. Your efforts to uncover a Soviet mole has proved you valuable once again. Will you accept the promotion to become a member of MI6's top three?
I accept.